हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट न्यूट्रिशन इन प्लांट्स. इन दैट वी स्टडीड अबाउट सोर्स ऑफ फूड एंड टाइप्स ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन. सो द टाइप्स ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन आर ऑफ टू टाइप, वन इज ऑटोट्रॉफिक एंड अदर वन इज एटेरोट्रॉफिक. सो ऑटोट्रॉफिक न्यूट्रिशन इज लाइक सेल्फ प्रोडक्शन ऑफ फूड, वेयर वी कैन डिस्कस इन दैट वीडियो इन ब्रीफ मैनर. टुडे वी गोइंग टू प्रोसीड अ न्यू टॉपिक, एटेरोट्रॉफिक न्यूट्रिशन. So the term etero means different, okay? So these type of organisms which depends upon other organism for food. So because there will be like what? There will be no process of photosynthesis will happen in this plant. So this plant obviously depends upon other organisms to get energy. So last class we discussed what is nutrition. So it is the process of taking in of food. And the energy which is stored within the food material is used by living organism for various activities. Nutrition occurs in several stages like ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation and adsorption. So the heterotrophic nutrition, the mode of nutrition in which organism cannot make its own food from simple inorganic material and depend on other organism for its food. The mode of nutrition in which organism obtain its food from decaying organic matter of dead plants, animals, rotten bread, etc. So heterotroph are the plants which is incapable of photosynthesizing. They are non-green, that is they lack of chlorophyll. They obtain certain organic compound from other autotroph. So based on the mode of nutrition, so these are classified into four types: parasitic, insectivorous, saprophytic and symbiotic. So the term parasitic, it means it depends upon the host. Okay, insectivorous, it means it feeds the insect. Saprophytic and symbiotic we will see in this detail. Parasitic nutrition, some heterotrophic plant depends on other plants and animal for nutrition. Such plants are known as parasitic plants. However, the host is not benefited from the parasite. For example, cascata. In parasitic mode of nutrition, plants depend on other plants or animals for their nourishment. Such dependent plants are called parasites, and the ones on which parasites depend are called host. A parasite plant climbs on the host plant from which they get all the food. The host does not get any benefit from the parasite. Some example of parasites are cascata. So here the parasite only gets benefit, not the host. The host of the plant will get what? Harmful, because of the plant which take all the success nutrition. Okay, so this is all about parasite. Parasites. In parasitic mode of nutrition, plants depend on other plants or animals for the nourishment. So such dependent plant or parasite and the one on which parasite depend on are called host. Okay, so the parasite is the thing where these are the plants which depend upon the other plant for its food production. So this is called parasite. I show you the example. Cascata. Okay, a parasite plant climbs on the host plant from which they get all the food. The host does not get any benefit from the parasite. Okay, so there will be like what? The host is like host. They won't get any benefit from the parasite, but the parasite is get fully benefit by the host. So only we are calling that as a parasite. Some example of parasites are cascata. So here you can see the branches, okay, the branches like a green color, no, that will be the cascata plant. So this is a parasitic mode of insectivorous nutrition. So insectivorous nutrition, the mode like the plant which feeds on insect to get a nutrition. Some plants have special structural features that help them to trap insect and are commonly known as carnivorous or heterotrophic plant. So these plants digest the insect by secreting digestive juices and absorb the nutrient from them. These plants grow on the soil that lack minerals. So These plant, what happened? This plant trap the insects and digest the insect to get the nitrogen. Okay, so the example will be pitcher plant and Venus fly trap. First, we study about pitcher plant. Pitcher plant has a pitcher shaped structure filled with liquid. So it has a flap like structure on its mouth. So there will be like a lid, okay? So there will be like opening and closing process. So the edge of the opening of the pitcher is very slippery, where the insects get attached to the slippery thing. Okay, why these insect comes and attach to the thing? Because this pitcher plant looks very beautiful. So these are the insect which can easily attracted by this plant. So the insect that sits on the slip and falls into the pitcher, getting trapped inside with the closing of the lid. So this will be the example of pitcher plant. Here you can see the diagrammatical view. Okay. The leaves of the Venus flytrap have stiff hair-like projection on their edges, and the entire leaf is divided into two parts, with the middle acting as a hinge. When an insect sits on the leaf, it shuts tightly and traps the insect inside it. So this will be the another example of insectivorous plant, that is Venus flytrap. Here you can see, right? Yes, the insect which sits on the leaf, but what happened? The leaf is shuts tightly by trapping the insect, and there will be the process of digestion will be take over. So this way the insectivorous plant feed the insects. Saprotroph. So this will be the another mode of heterotrophic nutrition. A mode of nutrition in which organisms or plants that obtain the nutrition from dead and decaying organic matter is called saprophytic mode. The plant which exhibits saprotrophic mode of nutrition are called saprotroph. Saprotroph secrete digestive juices onto dead and decaying matter to dissolve it and then absorb the nutrient from it. So example of saprotrophs are mold, mushroom, yeast and some bacteria. So this will be the example of saprotroph, okay, mushroom. Symbiotic nutrition. When two different plants belonging to two different category show a close association, they are termed as symbiotic. In this, both the plants are benefited from each other. So here you can see the symbiotic, it means they are the two plants, okay? So the two plants are closely related to each other and closely they were benefited each other. For example, the association of fungi and trees. You can see on the bark of the tree, you can see the fungi, okay? So this will be the perfect example of symbiotic nutrition. Difference between parasitic and symbiotic. The parasitic relationship, organism involved are called host and that are called parasites. So the organism involved are called symbionts. In symbiotic relationship, in parasitic relationship, the parasite is benefited, the host is harmed. In symbiotic, the organism involved are mutually benefited. In parasitic, have modified roots called astoria to suck the nutrients from the host plant. Here in symbiotic, no special structures are used. In parasitic, some parasites may make their host completely devoid of nutrition. In symbiotic, among symbiont, one of the organism provide nutrient while other provide protection or other benefits. So in symbiotic relationship, both the organisms are benefited, and in parasitic relationship, only one organism were benefited, that we called as a parasite. And how nutrients are replenished in the soil. We know that plants continuously take nutrients from the soil in order to synthesize food. As a result of this, amount of nutrients in the soil will be what? Decreases. So nutrients in the soil are replenished by adding fertilizer and manures. So the fertilizer and manures contain the plant's nutrient like minerals like nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. So another way to replenish soil is to grow leguminous crop, for example peas, pulses in the soil. The bacterium called rhizobium can take atmospheric nitrogen and convert into soluble form. So but rhizobium cannot make its own food. So it lives in the root of the gram of peas, mung, beans and other leguminous plants to provide them with nitrogen. In return, plants provide food and shelter to the bacteria. So thus plants and bacteria have a symbiotic relationship. So how you can replenish the soil in your home? Okay, so this will be the activity just I given to you. So you just take all the vegetable peels and fruit peels. Okay, so whatever the thing, like the organic matter, okay, organic matter which is easily held for decomposition. So you just collect all the dry leaves near your house or in the kitchen. So whatever the thing, okay, like the peel off from the kitchen. So you just take and you just keep into the soil, okay, pour some of the soil and later you can put all this peels, dry leaf, etc. So you can make your own fertilizer in your home itself. So this will be your activity to be done at your home. Okay, be safe. Thank you.